Hello, this is Harry Norman for Proactive Investors and welcome to another Proactive Audio interview. Today is the 29th of April 2010 and I'm talking with Patrick Harford, Managing Director of Mercator Gold, listed on the AIM market mining sector, stock ticker MCR, share price 2.62 pence, market cap 4.76 million pounds sterling, web address mercatorgold.com. Patrick, thank you very much for joining us for this interview.
Hello, Harry. Good to talk to you again.
Please give investors a brief introduction to Mercator Gold and the company's business model and your impending name change to Electrum Resources.
Harry, Mercator Electrum is a mineral development company with a business model that's quite distinct from that of conventional mining and exploration companies. We look to find value, and our board has that expertise and experience. We look to add value, and then we look to make sure we can realise the value. We've got an experienced management team. We've decided on a name change to Electrum Resources. Electrum is the naturally occurring alloy of gold and silver. We've done that largely because there's another company called Mercator Minerals, which is operating in southern Arizona with a very similar sort of project to Copper Flat, and we don't want confusion like that in the market.
Please tell investors about Mercator Electrum's interest in the Meekatharra Gold Project and what are your expectations of this interest?
The Meekatharra Project is still in the hands of an administrator. He has an offer on the table, which we believe will be finalised in the next 2 months from a Canadian group who hope to list the asset on the Canadian Stock Exchange. Mercator Electrum will have a retained interest in that company and will get back the control of the Australian subsidiary, which contains substantial tax benefits for Mercator Electrum.
Mercator Electrum has a 70% stake in ACS Asia, a business manufacturing cable support systems. Are you tempted to hold on to this investment as a handy cash cow, Patrick?
ACS is a very well-managed company with its own management structure that's operating very successfully. It's a profitable company with a turnover of about $10 million at the moment. We want to grow that business. How we then realise the value in Mercator Electrum is really dependent at the moment. We receive fees from the company as well as the benefits of profits. But we really want to, as with all of our assets, want to see that asset grow and develop.
What is the Silver Swan Group and how does your investment in Silver Swan and the sales part of your investment illustrate the Mercator Electrum Resources business model in action, Patrick?
Harry, 3 years ago we pegged some licences in Western Australia. We didn't spend a lot of money on them, but we eventually, after spending about $300,000, sold them to a company called Silver Swan Group Limited for 10 million shares and 4 million performance shares. Our shares were escrowed and in fact would have come out of escrow on the 29th of April. We received an approach in September last year from some shareholders of Silver Swan keen to buy that interest, and we approached the company in turn and were able to sell those 10 million shares for $3.5 million, which was a substantial return to them. Mercator Electrum and has allowed us to fund our work at Copper Flat. We still retain 4 million performance shares, which if the company is successful, we would expect those shares to become ordinary shares and to receive a considerable benefit. So we have, if you like, an option on success in Silver Swan. It's an exciting company with a very exciting discovery in Western Australia.
What is the situation with Panii Gold, in which you have about a 15% stake?
Panii Gold is an Australian company with a very, very exciting interest in the Papuan province of Indonesia. We recently, in Panii, have been granted a substantial tenement package for exploration, and we expect in short order, now that the regulations for the new Mining Act have been promulgated in Indonesia, we expect to be granted the rights to commence mining on what's a very exciting alluvial project. The area that we've pegged for mining, we believe it's produced over 100,000 ounces from alluvial beds that have been identified there, and we're very excited about the fact that will come into production during the course of this year, and we'll find out just what value it has. The exploration tenements are extensive, and we have there about 90 kilometres from the world's biggest gold copper mine, namely the Grasberg mine at Freeport, and so we have high hopes for the exploration areas as well.
In March, Mercator Electrum announced an agreement to acquire up to 70% of Ureno AG's uranium exploration and mining licences in Argentina. What attracted Mercator Electrum to these mining licences?
Harry, our board has considerable expertise in the area of uranium exploration, and we recognise that the tenements that Uranio AG have in Argentina are very, very well positioned. They lie near to some known uranium occurrences that have actively been mined by the Argentinian government in the past, and as you're probably aware, Areva are considering building some considerable uranium infrastructure in the country. We believe that it's quite possible that the uranium industry is about to go through a substantial resurgence in Argentina, and we are very well positioned with these tenements to take advantage of that. We have a prospector down there at the moment, and we'll soon be sending a very experienced geologist to review the data. It's suffice to say that this isn't just a grassroots exploration play. There are known uranium occurrences, and we believe that we're in a very good position to take advantage of what we think will be an upswing in the business down there.
Talk us through the work done to validate the historic resource at your copper, gold, molybdenum, silver project in New Mexico, and what are your expectations of the independent reserve and resource calculation expected in May?
Harry, we entered into the copper flat option as an option over the copper price itself. We got in last year when the copper price had fallen. Everything was a bit cheaper and it was a good time. We also saw that we could add value. We saw that with a modest increase in resources, copper flat would become bulletproof at, let's say, $1.50 or $1.60 copper. You'd certainly make a lot of money out of it at the present copper price. So we've pushed on to add that value by carrying out a 6,000-foot, 2,000-metre drilling program, which has given us indications that the pit could be pushed deeper. And so we've got SRK revalidating the resource and remodelling it, because the work was originally done in the late 70s. That was before computers had the power to analyse these things as effectively as they now can. So we're waiting with bated breath for the updated resource statement, which will come back from SRK in the next couple of weeks, and then we have a 43-101 compliant preliminary economic assessment being carried out by SRK, which should be finished sometime in the middle of June.
Mercator Electrum Resources has entered into an agreement to vend its interest in Copper Flat to the THEMAC Resources Group for an equity stake in the THEMAC. What is Copper Flat worth? What sort of stake will Electrum Resources acquire in the THEMAC? And does this indicate a possible ongoing relationship with the THEMAC, as you and Kevin Maloney have worked together before?
Initially, Harry, after the first stage of the transaction is completed and upwards of $7 million in total has been raised in the THEMAC for the project, we will have plus 50% interest in the project. Within short order, a further $10 million is expected to be raised. That's within the next 12 months. And at that time, we would have a 40% interest in the project. We intend to develop the THEMAC Resources as a substantial copper producer. And we've done business with the present major shareholder of the THEMAC. His name is Kevin Maloney. He's a substantial industrialist in Australia who provides accommodation to mining areas all throughout Australia. So the THEMAC is a transaction that follows our business model. We believe that a North American listing, a Canadian listing, in fact, is the appropriate home for this asset, that money will be more easily raised for it, and that we'll be able to attract the expertise to run this project very effectively into a company that's focused initially on the development of copper flat.
Mercator Electrum has entered into a standby equity distribution agreement, a CEDA, for up to £4 million with YA Global for a period of up to 30 months. What are the terms and the purpose of this CEDA?
Harry, the terms are such that we are able to designate when we want to raise capital and at what price and under what conditions. The CEDA is a very flexible unit that allows us to control far more carefully, depending, of course, on our liquidity, because it is driven by the liquidity in the stock, any placings that we might take using the CEDA. This gives us much more flexibility in the marketplace. It's an instrument that gives us greater flexibility.
And how does this leave Mercator Electrum's financial situation going forward?
Mercator Electrum is well financed. In the next 18 months, we are intending to and are capable of developing each of our projects to another level. And we want to make sure that the assets are liquid and we are able to reflect in our balance sheet what we believe to be the substantial increase in value that these projects represent. Mercator Electrum.
What can investors expect from Mercator Electrum over the next 12 to 18 months, Patrick?
We want to grow our business. We're very keen, now that we've identified these projects, to grow each of them, to make sure that they are capable, each one of them we believe is capable of representing substantial increase in market value to our shareholders. And our job is to take each of them and manage them through the process to realisation so that shareholders can clearly see that Mercator Electrum represents a repository of real value in excess of our market capitalisation.
Remember, Proactive Investors is not an investment advice service. Make sure you register at proactiveinvestors.co.uk for our weekly newsletter, which will keep you informed about our articles, interviews, and events. Thank you for listening. Please note, I hold shares in Meekatharra Gold.